International Raceway a lot, right? Does he compete in the Phoenix International Raceway a lot now, doesn't he? In that little track over there in Phoenix? Did a lot of the Nationals, and of course, he's out here on a Harley-Davidson, so watch out for Nigel Gale, the transplanted Englishman now racing over here in America. Oh, some of these riders getting a little anxious to get going. Formula USA riders, start forming down here in turn number 9. Remember, we need you for the introductions, so we're going to need all you Formula USA riders to converge down there in the turn 9 area, and then you'll be brought up to the pre-grid. So all you Formula USA riders, let's get up to the turn 9 area. You'll be coming out of the area, out onto the track from the turn 9 area, so we can introduce the top 5 riders so far. It should be 7:10, and it is Ray Adams out in front. Second spot, Dennis Kunster. Running in third spot, Fred Eicher, the leader in the Battle of the Twins class. Phenomenal Fred Eicher, who's the rider that won the La Corral race, competing against the likes of two-time Grand National champion Gary Nixon and Mark Brailsford, and Fred Eicher on that same machine. You see him out here right now, bike number 188. He is leading the event in that class. He's leading the class, and he's running third overall. Running down here in sixth position overall, bike number 26, that's Trevor Dunn. Then in seventh spot, 346, and that is Jim Smith on a Honda. Then in eighth spot overall, bike number 921. You don't have a 921 down here on my list. Bike number 799 is running in, Tom Christian in the 750 Twins. In fact, he's leading that 750 Twins class. 921 running in 8th spot overall. Then comes bike number 799. And that is Bill Easley on a Honda. And running out the top 10, bike number 33. And he's in the vintage class. Boy, a vintage Triumph running up there in the top 10. Brune Adderley. Coming out of turn number 9 with a big, big lead. This is going to be no contest at all for the over 40 rider, Ray Adams. Custer running in second spot. Eicher running in third and closing in on your second place rider. Look at this. Look at him go around turn number 1. Eicher can just pitch that machine illishly into the turn number 1. However, he doesn't have the horsepower in that short chute between 1 and 2. on the racetrack right now is between Kunstler and Eicher, both running in different classes, but Eicher would definitely like to have that second place. But he's got, he needs two more cylinders if he wants to do that. As Kunstler on that four-cylinder machine, Eicher leading the Battle of the Twins class, but making up a lot of real estate in the corners, but losing a lot in horsepower down the straightaways here. And of course, Willow Springs being a very fast track, it is shaped something like, well, it's not shaped anything like Road Atlanta, but turn-wise, a lot of the familiar turns, fast sweepers, that's what a lot of these riders are going to find at Road Atlanta. Still, Ray Adams out in front with Kunstler in second. Eicher trying to get into second spot, in third spot. That's close. Then comes Nigel Gale running in fourth spot on the Harley Davidson. He's also up there in the Open Twins class. Then comes Trevor Dunn. And then going down a little bit, let's look into that 250 modified production class. And looks like Willie Sarzi has got the lead right now over Morgan Ross on the Kawasaki, but just barely. And that's quite a duel there between those two Kawasakis. Those 250 modified production events. Willie Sarzi with the lead in the 250 category as they hit around turn number two. 7:15 and bike number four, and it's getting pretty close as they swing their way around turn number two right now and work their way up to the top of the hill. Formula USA riders. Formula USA riders up to the pre-grid, please. In fact, let's get up to the turn nine area of the pre-grid. Ray Adams already starting to get into lap traffic. There goes Willie Sarzi coming by as Ray Adams puts a lap on him. And he is just now just ahead of Morgan Ross. That battle for that 250 class still takes shape as Sarzi now with about a 2-3 second lead over second place in that class. Battling with him will now inherit second position. once again because of the chilly cook-off. There's going to be about, 50,000 spectators over there at that chilly cook-off. So you might want to stay away from that area going out to Highway 14. What you should do is catch Avenue 60 or Avenue 90 outside the racetrack here. Take us by the start-finish line, and he'll take the win in the 250 class. Evidently, we're going to have a few minutes at the end of this to kind of sort all this out and get pick up all the bikes and the debris out here. But it's going to lead us into the Formula USA event quite handsomely. So we'll be back with you there for the start of that and the introductions to that race. Next week, guys. There's going to be a race here next week, and the announcer, he's going to be coming out in his Gruel outfit. I'm going to be coming straight from a party, so I'm going to be coming out with my mask and everything. And it's going to be a Halloween racing weekend and next weekend. $150. So Iker was one of the riders that went down. 96. Nigel Gale's going to inherit the lead.